this is Stampy, and welcome to a Minecraft Let's Play video. Today I am doing another challenge against I, Ballistic Squid. We are doing the Don't Stop Challenge, and in this challenge we are not allowed to stop moving. Basically what we're going to be doing is taping our left analog stick on our controller forward. And so what that means is we basically cannot stop walking forward. So we're going to be non-stop walking around like this while trying to complete some tasks. And so the first thing we need to do is we need to make a block of redstone and place it there. And once we've done that, we take the tape off the controller and switch it round so it's then going to be taped backwards. And then we need to do the next challenge while having to walk backwards. And the next challenge is going to be to make a cooked fish sandwich. So we need two pieces of bread and a cooked fish. And it's basically going to be the first person to complete both challenges is going to be the winner. And we do have these nice little beds down here ready for us. And we also have ourselves some baked potatoes and one golden apple. But apart from that, we are going to be starting off with nothing, which means we've got to get all of our tools and everything ourselves. So the first thing I guess to do is to tape down the controller. So right, I'm going to go to bed first. And while in bed, I can go and try and start taping it down. So you can hear I've got some duct tape on me here. And I'm going to go and try and tape it down as properly as I can, just to make sure it doesn't fall forward. So there we go, a little bit more tape. I'm really doing a very thorough job here. I've kind of covered half the controller. And I guess, because it's always pointing forward, we're not going to be able to sprint either. And oh look, I'm off already. I can't stop moving. Right, when we're ready, we've got to press this button here to set off fireworks. But it's kind of hard to do it when we're moving. Right, I've pressed my button, which has launched my fireworks. Once Squid presses his button and launches his fireworks, then we can begin. I think he's having a bit of trouble. Right, it's off. We have began. This is the Don't Stop Challenge. So basically, I'm not doing anything with the left analog stick now. I'm just constantly walking forward, and there's not much I can do about it. So I think the first thing I want to do is to punch down some trees. And I think there's a few trees over here, which I should be able to punch down pretty easily. And oh, actually, something I didn't think about is, yeah, look, doing the menus. How are we going to do the menus? That is going to be really difficult because you need to use the left analog stick in order to do those menus. So I guess I'm going to worry about that a little bit later on. First, I'm going to go and try and cut down some trees. I guess if I stand here, so this way I'm kind of constantly walking into a single block, I think this is going to be the easiest way to do it. And then if I break away the final one last, there we go. That wasn't too painful. The thing I'm worrying about is when we get into a cave, because that's when there's going to be lots of googlies and things. And yeah, things might get dangerous. Or like a lava pit. Like imagine there's like a lava pit right in front of me and I'm walking towards, but I can't like turn around and walk back in the other direction. I guess I just gotta spin around in a circle. I think the only big thing that's gonna help us out is crouching. Even though crouching won't stop you, they make you walk slower. Or I guess if you are at an edge, it can stop you a little bit like that. So I think if I punch down one more tree, that should be enough wood for me to make all of my tools and torches and anything else I might need. And so the first thing to do is to dig straight down. So I need to make a redstone block. So that's 9 pieces of redstone dust, which you should get pretty easily. But you do need to dig down pretty deep in order to find it. And I also need to make... Whoa, easy. I'm all over the place. Yeah, I also need to make sure that I make an iron pickaxe, so then that way I can mine the redstone in the first place. And I did spot some coal over here. Actually, let's not worry about coal for now, because I'm going to find that anyway. Right, let's go try and find, if I can, the entrance to a good cave. Finding my way back to the house shouldn't be too hard, because there's the big beacon. Actually, let's have a look at the map. How am I going to have a look at that? Okay, I can't look at my map. How am I going to get things? There we go. Look at that. I was able to just about get to my map then. So yeah, let's kind of remember whereabouts I am. So I should be able to find my way back here. And this looks like an okay cave. Yeah, I guess I'm going down. And oh, I kind of regret not getting that coal now, to be honest. Hopefully, yeah, actually, I do want to get some coal before I go down there, because that is very, very, very dark. Let's backtrack for a little bit. Let's take things a little bit slower, and yeah, let's make sure I'm properly ready before I decide to go down. So there was a whole load of coal here. Let's make all of my torches and get all of that ready before worrying about going down. So let's go, and I guess I need to make a stone. Actually, I need to make a wooden pickaxe first, don't I? How is crafting going to work when we're always walking forwards while always holding up on the left analog stick? Hopefully this is going to be at all possible, otherwise things are going to get very difficult. So let's first, oh no, I can craft actually, because I can use the D-pad for that. Okay, this is okay then, this isn't too bad. Right, I now need to make some I need to make some sticks. That's not too bad. And then I also need to make myself a wooden pickaxe. So I can use this to start mining away some of this stone. And as soon as I've got enough to make myself some stone tools, I'm going to go and do that and gather up some of the torches. The only thing that's worrying me is I got to get my food somehow. I don't know how I can... Oh, I can kind of a little bit move it to the side. And then maybe if I can just grab those potatoes. Oh, that was close. That was close. Come on, get the potatoes, get the potatoes, get the potatoes, come on. Oh, so close, so close. There we go. I was able to just about grab my potatoes. This is ridiculous. This is so hard to do anything in the inventory. That's like an extra challenge that I didn't even really think about before we started. Right, but I've got a plenty of stone now, so I can go and make myself didn't mean to do that. Yeah, I can make myself a stone pickaxe now, just like that. And I guess I can just get rid of this old one, and I can go and start gathering up some of this coal so I can make myself some torches. And then I won't feel so worried about heading down into the cave, because at least I can light up. And actually also make myself a stone sword, which should have been probably one of the first things I thought about doing. And yeah, then we can go and head down and see if we can get the redstone. I think this game is going to be really won or lost on who gets the redstone block first. Even though afterwards we're going to be going backwards, which will be harder, I think getting the fish and the wheat isn't going to be as hard as getting the redstone. So I think this is the time to really try and play my best in order to get everything I need. So it would be good if I can just to get all of the coal I need now. So then that way when I'm in the dangerous cave, I don't really need to worry about it anymore. Rather than getting the coal as I go, because it's going to be so dangerous down in the cave, constantly walking and with all the googlies, I would rather just get everything that I need now and not worry about it when I'm down there. So I'm going to get quite a lot of coal here. I've almost got half a stack of coal already here, and there's still a little bit more here. So I'm going to get these last few blocks that are around here, and yeah, then we can make some torches. And I'm going to go back down to the cave that I saw before. So let's go and make some of these into torches, just so I have them ready. Let's make a few sticks, and then where are torches? I don't often make them on a crafting table, so I couldn't really find them. Then there we go, 48 torches. That should be okay. And oh no, now I need to find a way of getting them actually into my inventory, which is going to be another challenge. And there's a crafting table here as well that I can grab. Right, let's try and get these torches. Oh look, I'm kind of going the whole way around. It does seem that I'm kind of going up and slightly to the left, so that might make it a little bit easier. Oh, no, no, I took my boots off. I took my Stampy style boots off. That's no good. Right, I think I need to empty something out of my inventory, and then I need to try and go and grab it. Oh, that's nearly got it. Oh, nearly. No, not quite. Not quite. Come on. There we go. I got my boots back on at least. Can I get the torches? That's the big question. I'm getting really close. Oh, I got the crafting table. I don't really need that yet. I really need those torches, though. Come on, get them. There we go. I was able to just about get my torches. And oh no, I ended up crouched as well. Right, that's not very good. There we go. I'm standing up again. Right, let's go and head down to the cave. Oh, I realize I didn't make a sword. It's okay. It's okay. I think if I see a googly, I'm just going to run away anyway. I don't know how much a sword would help me, and I don't think I want to go through the whole hassle of putting down a crafting table and trying to make a sword again just yet. Actually, I think I need to. I think I need to. It shouldn't be too hard. If I throw away these saplings, the crafting table seems relatively easy to get. Oh, no, there go my boots again. There go my boots. I'm not going to worry about them for now. Can I get the crafting table? I'm just pressing Y as, like, fast as I can. And, oh, no, I got the wood, but not the crafting table. Well, let's go and throw away that wood for now and try and get the crafting table. I'm going right over it, but I'm not getting it. There we go. I've now got the crafting table here. I can go and make some more sticks, and I can now go and make myself my stone sword. I don't know, my stone sword's up there. I need to get better about clearing things from my quick select before trying to make these items, because otherwise they end up just here. So what I'm doing, as I go up, I'm just spamming on the D-pad to the right, and then that way I can try and get along to where I need to be. So there we go. Let's go and grab the crafting table again. If I throw away the sticks for now and the saplings, then that way the crafting table will be in my quick select, and then I won't need to worry about it later on. That's a pretty good idea, actually. So that's the, I think, the way I'm going to worry about doing this in the future. So where was the tunnel I found? It wasn't this one, was it? Have I gone past it? Is it over in this direction somewhere? I think this might have been it here. Yeah, I think this is where I went to go before. So now I got my torches. I'm a little bit less scared than I was before. I'm still a little bit scared, but not quite as scared as the first time I went down here. At least I can try and light it up. And oh, does it keep going down? It does. Okay, I thought it was going to end right then, but it does seem to be going down a little bit deeper. And oh, looks like I've got my first googly. I'm definitely glad I decided to go back and make the stone sword. I definitely want to get an iron one as soon as I can, because that would help me out big time. So I really just want to go as deep as I can. And oh no, here's lava. Okay, got to be careful, we're going to avoid it. Let's just go the other direction from the lava, shall we? That might be a might be a smart idea. Oh no, I can't go any further this way, but this is a relatively easy now. Steady. Yeah, this is a... Oh, no. I was going to say it's a safe place to get iron, but there is gravel. I don't think there's too much, so I should be okay, though, to go and gather up a little bit of this iron, which is going to be very useful later on for making an iron sword and an iron pickaxe. Possibly some iron armor as well, depending on how much I get. So it looks like I am going to have to go and run past this lava. So if I stay... Oops, straight to the side. Remember, I can't stop moving. I can't turn around. I gotta keep going forward. This is the don't stop challenge. Right, let's go down. Can we go down anywhere lower? Aha, I think I can go down this way. This isn't where I've come from. I can see more light, which makes me think there's lava. Ah, there is a torch there, which means I have been close by, but I don't think I've been down this way yet. And it looks like there's a little bit more iron. I'm going to go forward a little bit, though, and just make sure there's no googlies waiting around this corner before I think about grabbing the iron, and it seems okay. So yeah, let's go back here, and let's go and try, if I can, mine this up while trying to keep walking all over the place. And then I'm going to go and make myself a furnace, so then I can start smelting the iron, and I can make myself an iron sword and an iron pickaxe, and then I should have everything that I need to keep going forward and go and actually get the redstone. So the next challenge is just going to be to get as deep as possible so I have a chance of actually running into the redstone. So let's go and put all of this away here. And I now need to go and put down my crafting table, and let's see how easy or difficult this is going to be. So making the furnace should be easy enough. Yep, I can make that and plonk it right down there. I now need to try and get the iron into the furnace. How's this going to work? This is going to be difficult. Right, so I think I can get the coal in, maybe? I don't even know how I'm going to get the coal in, actually. Right, I don't actually know if this is possible. What happens if I just leave it? It kind of just ends there on the top of the screen. I need to smelt it. I need to get an iron pickaxe somehow. But how am I going to do this? I think I just need to completely like jig around everything in my pockets so I can do it. Because I can't even throw away the iron that I already have. Let me just go and hold as much to the left as I can as it's going up, and just see if I can get the iron in there. It's difficult, though, to get it. Oh, there we go! I did it! How about that? Right, that's step number one. Step number two is to get the coal. And right, I think I've got an idea of how I can do this. If I throw away the sword like this, and then if I throw all of the coal away as well, then that way, if I pick up the coal first, it should be in the first place in my quick select, and I might be able to do it that way. So if I just throw it all the way down like this, and there we go. Oh no, I did pick up the sword first, but it is much further forward, and now I think I got more chance of getting the coal in. Or actually, I could even just put the wood in if I can. See the wood that's up there? It wouldn't be as good as the coal, but it would be okay. Right, let's see if I can get the wood in, or at least the coal. Nope, I got rid of the sword. Right, let's go and try and do this again with the coal. If I drop it and then pick it up again, it should put it in the first place. And then there we go. Now it should be much easier to try and get it into the furnace. So let's try and do it. There we go! I can't believe I was able to make that work. Let's see if I can do the same with my Stampy style boots. This is such a weird way to play Minecraft, isn't it? It's just like the most simple things that shouldn't be a challenge are just a huge challenge for me now. Right, so I think the iron should be there already. Well, it should be smelting away. And as soon as it is, I'm going to go and try and yeah, make myself an iron sword. So I might as well look forward a little bit further and see where I want to go next. Oh, there's a big hole there. I'm glad I didn't drop down. And the tunnel seems to keep going further down that way. So this actually seems to be a pretty good cave. Not a bad find whatsoever. So I should have a little bit of iron in here. And what I can do is actually just break the furnace once it's all finished smelting, and then that way I don't need to worry about trying to get all of the items out of it. I think that might be the easiest way to do this. So I might as well gather up some of this iron and things while I'm waiting, because there's not too much else for me to do. And then I'm just going to go and grab whichever iron's finished smelting and yeah, carry on going down to get the redstone, because I have no idea how well Squid's doing. Of course I can't see him, I have no idea what he's doing, but he is uploading his view though. So yeah, there will be a link in the description to his video if you want to check out what he is doing right now and see if he's struggling as much as I am. Right. I made my items, but once again, I didn't think about how I'm going to get them into my quick selects. I really want to get them right down here. So let's just go and throw away some things that I don't really immediately need. I don't really need the map too much. And now let's see if I can get over to the to the sword and the pickaxe. Oh, it's going to be tough, actually. It's going to be tough. Let's go and try and do it. Oh, nearly. Oh, I nearly got the pickaxe then, at least. Not the sword, but at least the pickaxe. There we go. I got the pickaxe ready. And how much iron do I have? Do I have enough to make another iron sword? Because I think that might actually be easier. There we go. Rather than trying to get the other iron sword, I think it's actually easier just to make a new one. So now, I don't think that I really have to do much more crafting at all. I should be ready just to go straightforward and try and find the redstone. So let's go down this way first, shall we? It seems to go quite deep down here. I want to have my sword at hand. Hopefully I'm almost low enough now to have a chance of finding some redstone, and as soon as I do, I'm going to be trying to get out of this cave as quickly as I can. Oh, I can see some light down there, which, yep, it means there's going to be lava around here, so I want to be careful. Once again, I'm just going to try and ignore the lava and go in the opposite direction. Oh, found an emerald and redstone. Look, I found redstone right here. Sadly, though, it's right next to some lava, so I'm going to be very careful. If I stay back here, oh, and googlies, and there's a zombie, and there is a zombie. This is good, though. This was a good find to find this redstone this early on. Let's go and try and stand here. And because I've made a little hole, if I crouch, then that way I shouldn't go anywhere further forward. So it was 9 pieces of dust that I needed. So let me go and try and get this one. And how many pieces have I got? I have 9. I have the exact perfect amount I need to make myself a redstone block. So now all I need to do is find my way out of this cave, which is actually easier said than done. I know that there's more redstone down here anyway. Might as well go and grab this. Hopefully there's no lava underneath. Nope, well, there is a little bit, but not too much. And another emerald. I've never found like this many emeralds close together before. Yeah, so now challenge number 2 is for me to be able to get out of this cave. But sadly, we have just about run out of time in this episode here. But don't worry, I will be continuing the next episode of the Don't Stop Challenge very soon. So there'll be a link to that in the description once it's online. But for now, I want to thank you all very much for watching. And I will see you all later. Bye!